Hi, welcome to Edupedia World. Today we will learn basis of accounting. It is basically the method we use to determine when we should record our revenues and expenses or when we should recognize the revenues and expenses while preparing our accounts. When we do any business, there is a gap between the date on which the transaction happens and the payment or receipt related to that particular transaction actually being paid or received. And because of this gap, we have to take a decision whether to recognize or record the transaction on the date of transaction or to record it on the date of payment or receipts related to that transaction. Therefore, there are two types of accounting or basis of accounting. One is cash basis of accounting and the other is accrual basis of accounting. And whichever basis we choose for our accounting, we need to disclose it in our accounts. Please note that for certain types of companies or for certain categories of companies, preparation of accounts is mandatory only on the basis of accrual basis of accounting. So now let's understand this cash and accrual basis of accounting one by one. In cash basis of accounting, revenues or incomes are recognized or recorded when received. So on the date of receipt of money, that sale of goods or services is recorded. Similarly, the expenses are recorded on the date of payment. Let's understand it by examples. These are two examples of cash basis of accounting. In example one, a shopkeeper sells a refrigerator on 15th of January, but he receives the money on 20th of January. So if he is following this cash basis of accounting, his entry for sales will be done on 20th of January and not on 15th of January. In our second example, a businessman purchases a customized bus for his factory and pays 1 month in advance, that is on 25th of March. So it means he will receive the bus on 25th of April. But as he is following cash basis of accounting, he will record the purchase on 25th of March itself and it won't be entered as advance payment for bus, rather it will be entered as purchase of bus or addition to the asset. Now let's understand accrual basis of accounting. In accrual basis, revenues or incomes are recognized when earned, which means the date on which the sale is made or the goods are dispatched and we have generated the sales invoice from our accounting system. On that particular day itself, our sales will be recorded, irrespective of the fact whether we received the payment on the same date or later. And similarly, expenses are recognized or recorded when incurred, which means the date on which we have purchased that item or we have purchased a particular service and we are liable to pay for it, on that particular day itself we will record the expense in our accounts. So this is accrual basis of accounting. Now let's understand it better with examples. For better understanding, I have taken the same two examples here. Now in accrual basis, when the shopkeeper sells a refrigerator on 15th of January and receives money on 20th of January, the entry for sale will be done on 15th itself and the amount to be received from the customer will be shown as receivable. And in our second example, where the businessman had paid for bus 1 month in advance, that is on 25th of March, so on 25th of March an entry will be done as advance payment for bus, but the purchase entry for the bus or the addition to the asset will be done only when he will receive the bus, that is on 25th of April, and the advance entry made on 25th of March will be adjusted or squared off with this purchase entry on 25th of April. So that's accrual basis of accounting. We have covered both the basis, cash and accrual. Thank you.